ever since I first appeared on The Last Leg back in 2012, there's been something obvious about me that everyone's immediately noticed. That's right, my love of language. I first fell in love with it as a journalist. Using words in florid ways encouraged my enchantment with their etymology. I became increasingly inquisitive about their history and fascinated by semantics. So I've devised a linguistic quiz in the hope that you can share my enthusiasm for the beauty of language. So, first up, fart, fuck or dick, which word is the oldest?
That's your opening.
I actually feel like, as an Australian, I do actually have an unfair advantage.
Rhea, what have you gone for?
I went with dick. Just because, pictorially, it made the most sense.
So, what word do you think is the oldest?
I've gone with fuck. But only because I vaguely remember someone saying that it was an acronym for fornication under Crown and King.
Richard, what you got?
So I went for the same. But I actually remember from the Van Halen liner notes that I feel it was for unlawful carnal knowledge.
So, the first F-bomb was detonated back in 1568, which was presumably also the first time someone hit their thumb with a hammer. dick wasn't used until 1891.
That's right.
Which means the right answer and the oldest word is fart.
Mm. Oh.
Yes. Fart first slipped out and got blamed on a dog in the mid-13th century. Question number two. What I want to know is, what term refers to when you put a word, usually a swear word, in the middle of another word for emphasis? For example, is Alex a wordsmith? Abso-fucking-lutely would be that in action. Okay? So, your options are gamahoosh, temesis, acnestis.
I think temesis, you just got that from acnestis. Bohemian Rhapsody, that first word.
So, Rhea, what do you think is the correct answer?
Yeah, I went for Tememesis.
Tememesis.
Yeah, that one.
Sarah?
I've gone with Acnestis. It's just got a really strong vibe.
Richard, what you got?
Tememesis.
Do you genuinely know this?
Final answer.
Final answer. OK. Let's go through the answers. Gamahoosh is actually, it's Victorian slang for oral sex. Fittingly, it's a bit of a mouthful. Acnestis is the bit between your shoulder blades, which you can't reach. The term for parts of my body I can't reach is pretty much everything. which means the correct answer is temesis.
Wow, there you go.
That's a point for you, Rhea, and a point for you, Richard. You knew that one, didn't you?
Of course I did.
So, the next question. What does the 18th century word rantalian mean? Is it a randy old man who marries a woman much younger than him? Is it a posh person with big teeth? Or is it someone with a scrotum longer than their penis?
Why would you have a word for that?
Have you met many rantalians, Richard?
I mean, obviously, how would I know option three? I mean, I don't go to the gym.
Rhea, what do you think the word rantalian means?
I went for an old man with a young wife.
Okay. Judging by your picture, that is a much, much younger wife.
No, she's, well, she's legal in the 18th century. Can I
okay,
be clear?
Cool. Okay, moving on. Sarah, what you got?
I answered the same, but only because it just reminded me of the word rapscallion.
Richard, what you got?
Old man with a young wife.
Old man with a young wife, so you've all gone for that. Let's go through the answers. A posh person with big teeth is actually called a keffel, as in keffel, you don't have someone's eye out with your big teeth. A randy old man with a much younger wife is known as a legend. No, I don't know. It's not really, it's 2021, guys. They're known as an Oxhauser, which means the correct answer, rantalian, is someone whose scrotum is longer than their penis, which is totally normal, right?
I'm surprised that people felt so put out by having to explain it at length that they just wanted to shorten it to one term.
Yeah,
I keep having to say this. Can we just coin a name for this? I'm losing hours here.
My final round, I've got a challenge for you based on the Ofcom guidelines about what you're not allowed to say on television. I'm going to show you a list of Ofcom's bad words. And what I want you to do is rank them in order of how rude Ofcom consider them to be using the clearest scale known to man, the Nando's periometer. For example, you're very mild, probably OK for kids. Lemon and herb word would be something like bloody.
Yes. Still would quite be... hot for me, though.
Well, a medium word would be bollocks.
Oh.
Yeah?
Yeah. Back it up, mister.
And a hot word would be wanker. For your last 2 points, you face my Great Wall of Swearing.
Wow.
Here's how the game works. Each of you will select 3 swears from the board, but choose carefully, because you're looking for just 1 mild, 1 medium, and 1 hot. So, Rhea, what would you think would be a mild swear word?
I'm going to go with sod off.
OK.
So I'm going to go, mild. I'm going to go git.
Git?
Yeah.
Yes, it's nice. Yeah. There are days when I'm sad that both my parents are dead. And then there's today.
Richard, what would you think would be a nice mild swear word?
I want to say crap.
All right, then. Let's kick it on a notch. Mm. Rhea, what do you think it would be a medium?
I'm going to go with something female, because I remember seeing the list years ago and every female part was more offensive than the male parts for some reason. So I'm going to go twat.
You're going to go for twat. Okay. Okay. Sarah, what have you gone for a medium?
For a similar reason, I'd go tits.
Yeah. Tits. Richard, what are
I
you thinking?
I don't know what bakake is. How... What is that? What is that?
I mean, do you want me to explain?
Yeah, I would.
Can I get an iPad? I can draw.
No.
I don't know what that means.
I can't say it. I think it's with the Ofcom thing.
Okay, so that...
Do you want me to, whisper it?
Okay, so that's my choice for 3.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, then, so...
I'll pencil Bukake okay, for
3. You're penciling Bukake for 3.
And then for 2, I'll say bastard.
Right. One more. Tricky. Hot. What are you going for, Rhea?
Oh, he just took my 3.
Although he penciled.
Can I change that to a hard pencil? Unless that relates to whatever the word means.
Rhea, what do you think?
I'm going to go jizz.
You go for jizz?
I'm going to go jizz, like the cocky adjacent, right?
Sarah?
God.
God?
Ooh.
Richard, you've gone for cocky. You've penciled it.
I'm not going to choose a word that I don't know what it means, because...
Are you not taking bukkake? Because if you're not, I'm having it.
Take bukkake.
I'll have bukkake, please.
OK, you're going to have bukkake.
Yes,
take it.
OK, very generous of you, Richard.
I will go, so to speak, for arsehole.
You're going to go for arsehole?
Yes.
Got your answers locked in. So, Rhea, let's see if you know your swear words. The first one you went with was sod off.
Yeah.
Let's see how that rates. Well done. It's a mile.
So, Alex, just, I'm interested, so that's any time of day?
Yeah, sod off is mild any time of day, doesn't it? You can say, you could literally just say sod off on, like, breakfast telly.
Scoff, sod off.
Wow.
Yeah.
Here's the weather.
Yeah. Do you see our twat rates?
Yeah.
Of course we do. That's too steep.
See, I told you, women's
bits. That's strong
meat.
But... If jizz is medium, then you still win 2 points. Let's have a look at jizz.
No.
That's a 3.
Oh, no. Sarah?
Yeah.
Let's see how you did.
I feel good about this. I feel very confident.
You went with git.
Yes.
It's a mild. See what it is?
Yeah.
It is mild.
Yes.
Yeah. You went for
Here's
tits.
That git. Holly Willoughby with the next item.
You went with tits?
I went with tits.
As a medium. Oh! Yay! And for the 2 points,
lovely.
Is bukkake a hot word?
Yes!
Yay!
Nice, isn't it?
It's not bad. I feel like I'm back in the game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Go on. Richard, how do you feel about your words? Do you think you've got the full house for the 2 points as well?
I'm quietly confident.
Okay.
That was a crap item, Piers. Yeah, I think it works.
Is crap a mild word?
Yes.
Yes. It is. Is bastard.
I've definitely heard that on EastEnders.
Medium word.
What?
Ooh,
I've literally hot. Heard after that word. I've said that word before nine on TV. Actually, people did complain. They did complain.
Arsehole, if that's medium, then you've had a result. You still get 2 points.
It's not medium. How can arsehole be more medium than bastard?
Well, we'll see, won't we?
All right.
Let's have a look.
Ah!
Stop it.
Ah! It hurts.
2 points, Richard.
Oh,
and 2 points for you, Sarah. Congratulations.
Oh, it's a pet.
So, for everyone playing at home, let's see what all the other words are worth. What we've got over there. There you go. Yeah. So you got...
Bastard.
Yeah, bastard.
Damn.
So shit is only medium. So, Rhea, you got one, Sarah got two, and Richard got three.